Hello, welcome to my talk on the derivations of Bernoulli's equation. This is the second part of the topic. In here, we will derive the Bernoulli's equation based on the streamline equations. As in this talk, I will introduce Euler equation and the streamline equation first. And then I will apply the streamline equation to the Euler equation on the convective acceleration terms. And then the derivation of the conventional Bernoulli's equation in step-by-step approach. And at last, two examples we have used to show how we can use Bernoulli's equation. As we know, the Bernoulli's equation is derived from the Euler equation, and the general Bernoulli's equation is based on the steady Euler equation. This, the Euler equation in the Cartesian coordinates, see here, and the velocity vector v has three components, u, v, w, around x-axis, y-axis, and z-axis, respectively. And in the Euler equation, we termed each moment equation as equation 1, equation 2, and equation 3. And in here, we can see on the left-hand side of these equations, they are the convective acceleration along x-axis, y-axis, and z-axis. And this is the component of the pressure gradient. And this is the gravitational acceleration because of the coordinate this. So the fluid gravitation is on the opposite direction of z, thus minus sign here. And we also know on the general Bernoulli's equation, the Bernoulli's equation is only valid on the streamline. The streamline is a line on which the velocity vectors are tangent to the line everywhere. And the mathematical expression for the streamline would be given as vector v cross timing d vector s equaling to zero. This expression means v and ds would be in the same direction. And this streamline equation can be also written as this. And in the application, the streamline equation would be written as this. Here, we can use u to represent v and w. Or we can use v to represent u and w, use this expressions, or we can use W to represent U and V, use these expressions. And in the derivation of the Bernoulli's equation based on the streamline equations, all this equation would be used in the following slides. Here in this slide, we look at the first moment equation in the Euler equation given as this. And here we will use the streamline equation given as this. Here, v and w would be represented by u on the streamline. So the left-hand side of the Euler equation, the first moment equation of the Euler equation is given this, and we substitute the velocity v and w into the equation. We have this, and we can take u out of the expression. We have this. Now we can multiply the equation 1 by dx. Then the moment equation would become as this. Or we can write this equation as this, and we can change this into this here, u squared And obviously, in this bracket, it is du squared. So we have the moment equation at this. Now in this slide, we look at the second moment equation given at this. And in here, we will use v to represent u and w on the streamline. Thus, the left-hand side of the moment equation would be calculated as this if we substitute u and w into the expression. So we can take v out. Now, we can multiply the moment equation 2 by dy. The equation would become as this. And we can obtain this and this. This bracket would be the differential of v squared. For the third moment equation, we can substitute u and v use the relation this, so we can have the expression as this and this. Now we can time the equation 3 by dz. The equation would become as this. This equation would be very similar to the first two moment equation, but with the extra term here. Minus g means the gravitational force is in the opposite direction of z. So we can write this equation as this, and we will have the expression for the third moment equation. Again, the expression in the brackets would be the differential of w squared. Now, we can add all these three equations together for this, this, and this. So we have the expression on the left-hand side, this, 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 and this. So, we put all this velocity component together. We have this, and take this 1 over rho out of this expression. So we can see in the bracket is actually the differential of pressure. So the expression can be expressed as this. Capital V squared is the sum of this 3 velocity component squared. And this is the differential for the pressure. When we consider incompressible flow, density is a constant. Then we can write this equation as this. The differential of the expression is 0. Integrate this, we have the Bernoulli's equation. Here C is the integral constant. It is the total pressure in the fluid. Now we will see one example for applying the Bernoulli's equation. The question is a water pipe. See this plot. With an inlet at A1, R1 equaling to 0.2 meter, and a smaller outlet at A2. R2 equaling to 0.1 meter. The height, h, is 2.5 meter. Suppose the flow rate is 1 cubic meter per second. The water density, rho, is 1000 kg per cubic meter. The question is to find the flow velocity V1 at A1 and V2 at A2, and the pressure difference between A2 and A1, P2 minus P1. Solution. We can calculate the section area. A1 is given as this, and A2 is given as this. Thus, V1 is calculated as the flow rate divided by A1. It is 7.96 meters per second, and V2 is the flow rate divided by A2 given as this. So we have the velocity 31.85 meters per second. Here, when we calculate the velocity V1 and V2, we assumed the velocity at A1 and A2 would be uniform. Thus, we can apply the equation V1 equaling to Q divided by A1 and V2 equaling to Q divided by A2. Based on Bernoulli's equation, we have this 3 times at A1, because this 3 times added together would be constant. That means at A1, we have this 3 times, and at A2, we have this 3 times. Therefore, we can calculate P2 minus P1 given as this expression. Z1 is here and Z2 is here, so Z1 minus Z2 would be minus H. So we can calculate the pressure P2 minus P1 given as this from this term and this from this term. So it is roughly equaling to minus 500 kPa. So from this calculation, we can see P2 is smaller than P1. It seems this is understandable because P2 is at a higher position. But we must see the contributions of the pressure based on the Bernoulli's equation. This part for the pressure reduction due to the higher position at A2. So it is minus 24,500 pounds. And a large pressure reduction came from this part due to the higher velocity at A2. It is minus 475,000 pascals. The second example for the Bernoulli's equation is the similar pipe, but at A1, we have a smaller inlet, R1 equaling to 0.1 meter, and we have a large outlet at A2, R2 equaling to 0.2. The height is near 2.5 meter, and the flow rate is 1.0 cubic meters per second, and the water density is 1000 kg per cubic meter. And the question is to find the velocities V1, V2, and the pressure difference P2 minus P1. Similarly, we can calculate the section areas first. A1 given as this, and A2 given as this. Thus, we can calculate the velocity V1 given as this. So it is 31.85 meters per second. And V2 equaling to Q, the flow rate divided by A2. So it is 7.96 meters per second. So again, we can use the Bernoulli's equation. This part at A1 and this part at A2, but they are constant, so they are equaling each other. Thus, we can calculate P2 minus P1 given as this expression. So we substitute the values into this expression. We can calculate the pressure difference P2 minus P1. And now we have positive value. It is 451 kilopascals. So here we can see the pressure P2 is much larger than P1. This is contradicting with our sense. since P2 at the higher position, the pressure should be lower than P1. But based on the Bernoulli's equation, we can see the pressure difference is contributed by two parts, a small pressure reduction due to the higher position at A2. It is minus 24,500 parts. And in here, a large pressure increase due to the lower speed at A2. It is 475 kPa. So put all this together, we got the higher pressure at P2 because the lower velocity at P2. So in this regard, the Bernoulli's equation would give some counterintuition result, like this here, P2 is larger than P1. But this is correct. We will see more examples for using the Bernoulli's equation in the following talks.